Why do you think so many agents will not do the prospecting or the cold calling, or, you know, where they say like, oh, I'm too good for that? Why do you see that? I've always been curious from an agent's perspective, why you think that is so.
Well, I think two things. I think the very first thing on top of everything, and they won't admit it, but they're just scared to make the calls, right? That's the first thing. And then the second layer of that is the fact that there are so many other things out there that tell you you can build your business this other way other than making calls. And so they're using that as an excuse to cover up the fact that they're scared to make calls, you know? And so there's all these things out there that gives you plenty of excuses not to make calls, you know, and they're taking them, they're eating them up. You know, they're just, you know, give me that, give me this, whatever. I just don't want to make calls. And what's so funny is that all these other methods, right? Buy leads, you know, social media leads, you know, leads from here, leads from there, whatever. All that is doing, what you have to do once you get one of those leads you pay for, what do you have to do?
You got to get back to them.
What's that?
You got to get back to them. You got to call them.
You got to call them. You got to call them. Now what are we doing? We're right back to the thing that we didn't want to do, right? Every single closing originated from a conversation that turned into a relationship. Every single closing on the face of the planet, the history of the world, came from a conversation that resulted in a relationship that turned into that transaction. Okay? There's no way around that. So, you know, voice to voice is the reason why technology hasn't and will not replace real estate agents. There has to be that voice-to-voice consultation through this person's probably their largest financial decision in their life, you know, and nobody's going to buy a house online because there's foundation problems, there's roof problems, there's inspections, there's this, there's that, right? So you need a professional to help you through the process. You know, it's not as easy as buying a pair of sneakers and they just show up at your house. You know, it's a little bit more complex than just buying a dress online. So, you know, all we're doing when we're buying leads, we're just prolonging the inevitable, the phone call. You know, so what we're doing is all we're doing. Okay, so to make a sale, you have to talk to people, right? In other words, make phone calls. You have to make phone calls to make transactions happen. And so if you're trying to avoid that to do this other thing, well, that's just putting time and money because it's going to take longer to get that lead because you're waiting on the lead to come in and you're paying money for the lead. So you're putting time and money between you and that phone call that you have to make anyway. And all I'm saying is let's just do away with this money and time that we're putting in between you and the phone call and eventually the transaction and just let's go straight to the phone call, right? And so that's the way I look at it is that people, there's so much of this where agents are putting time and money in between them and what they inevitably have to do anyway. And it's all because they're just scared to make calls, but they're going to have to make the call anyway. So you have to break through that fear. So here's the thing. There's stages of cold calls and everybody goes through the same exact stages, right? You start out scared to death. Everybody does. I did. Everybody that's made phone calls, everybody, right? So if I start out scared to death, then why shouldn't you have to go through that same thing? You know, where it's a natural thing. We're scared. Okay, but the top producers know that they have to fight through that, get out of their comfort zone in order to grow. So they bust through that fear and they make the call. So the next stage is they made the call and they realize, wait a minute, that didn't kill me. You know, that wasn't as bad as I thought. And so they make some more calls and some more calls and some more calls, right? So then they get to the stage where they're making a bunch of calls but not finding a lot of success, okay? So now they go to the next stage, which is, okay, now let's learn what to say. Now we got to learn what to say, okay? We were scared, then we make calls, now we're making a bunch of calls, now we got to learn what to say. Okay, and then when you get to that stage, the next stage is, okay, now we know what to say, now we gotta learn how to say it in terms of reading people on the phone, right? That's the next level is, you know, when I'm making calls, when they answer the phone, I can tell by the tone of their voice right there how that call is gonna go most of the time, You know, I'm probably like a 90% chance that I know exactly how this call is going to go. Because once you've made so many calls, you realize there's only a couple outcomes. You know, they're nice, they're mad, they hang up on you, they give you their email, they want to do a deal, they don't want to do a deal, they already have an agent they work with. There's only a handful of different outcomes, you know, that's going to happen in this phone call. You know, and then once you realize and you can start to hear, you can hear the tone of their voice, you kind of know where the conversation is going, and you can kind of figure out where this call is going to end up. You know, so that's just the stages of being a cold caller. And I mean, that cold caller is the same thing as a top producer, you know, like if you go and, you know, the top producers know that everything's a stage. Everything's just a different stage and a different level. And the top producers, they know that, and they're going to get through that stage as quick as possible so they can get to the next stage, the next stage, the next stage. And they don't let fear hold them back.